In this video, we're going to discuss the difference between mass and weight. Then we're going to derive this simple formula, weight equals mg, that's mass times the acceleration of gravity, for computing the weight of a mass m. Next, we define the normal force acting on a mass, and we learn how to calculate the normal force. And finally, we're going to work several examples to illustrate how to apply these new ideas. So starting with mass, we can get technical about this and say that mass is the resistance to acceleration. This is an appeal to Newton's second law, which we could write as A equals F over M, where we can see that doubling the mass will cut the acceleration in half, so mass is the resistance to acceleration. Informally, though, we can just say that mass is the amount of stuff that we're talking about, and the SI units of mass are kilograms. Weight, on the other hand, is defined as the force of gravity on a mass. The weight is actually a force, which means the SI units of weight are newtons. So the main goal here is to figure out, given a mass in kilograms, what's the weight in newtons? To figure this out, it's useful to run a little thought experiment, and the experiment goes like this. Let's release a mass m from rest, and simply allow it to free fall to the ground. What we observe is that the mass falls with a constant downward acceleration with magnitude g, which is about 9.8 meters per second squared near the surface of the Earth. And in order for the acceleration of this mass to be downward, it must be feeling a downward force. And that's the force of gravity pointing down. But we also know the relationship between force, mass, and acceleration is given by F equals ma, that's Newton's second law. But we already observed the acceleration, A was g, so we can say the force of gravity on this thing is F equals mg. And this is the big payoff of our experiment. We determined that the force of gravity pointing down on a mass of m is given by mg. Now we usually use the lowercase letter w for this, because the force of gravity on a mass is what we call the weight of the mass. Now that we know how to calculate weight, it's natural to look at the normal force. Normal force is the force a surface exerts at right angles in order to keep an object from pressing through the surface. In other words, we can say it's the force exerted perpendicular to a surface in order to support an object. And we run another simple thought experiment. Our simple example here is just a box with a mass of m sitting on a level surface, and we want to figure out how hard is the surface pushing on the box. Now we know how to compute the weight of the box. And that weight vector, the force of gravity, just points downward and has a magnitude of mg. If that was the only force on the box, it would start accelerating downward. But that's not going to happen because there's a surface in the way. In fact, the box stays stationary, which means there must be an upward force. And that upward force must also have a magnitude of mg to guarantee that it exactly cancels the force of gravity. That's the normal force. And we figured it out by simply asking, what does the surface have to do here to guarantee that the perpendicular forces add to zero? Another way of saying that is that we're guaranteeing there is no acceleration perpendicular to the surface, which means the object is constrained to the surface. Note that the normal force is equal to mg in this example, but don't fall into the trap of thinking n is always equal to mg. If we have any other forces tampering with the vertical direction, or if the surface is tilted, n is not going to be mg, but n is always what it needs to be in order for the object to stay in contact with the surface. In other words, it's there to guarantee that the forces perpendicular to the surface add to zero. Now we put our new ideas into practice with a few short examples. In our first example, we have a 2 kilogram block hanging from a string. There's a tension of T in the string, and the tension is pulling hard enough to cause an upward acceleration of 3 meters per second squared for this block. And the goal here is to compute that tension. So we began by putting force vectors into this diagram. What are all the forces acting on that 2 kilogram block? Well, one of those forces is the force of gravity pulling down on the block, and that's given by the mass multiplied by g, the acceleration of gravity near the surface of the Earth. And the second force acting on this block is the tension in that string pulling upward. Notice that I made the tension vector a little bit longer than the weight vector. And the reason why is that I know the net force points upward. Otherwise, I wouldn't have an upward acceleration here. So that upward vector better be a little bit longer than the downward vector. Now we could plug in m and g and find the force of gravity here, but it's probably best to just find a symbolic solution to the problem, and then we'll go ahead and plug in m. So to analyze the problem, we just write down Newton's second law. That's F net equals ma, and there's nothing going on in the x direction here. So really, this is just an analysis of what's going on in the y direction. I want F net in the y direction is equal to m times a in the y direction. And we're going to choose a coordinate system where upward is positive. And that makes the tension positive. So when I'm finding my net y vector, tension counts as positive. The weight mg pointing down counts as negative. And that's going to be equal to the mass times a, which is the y acceleration of the mass. To solve for the tension here, we just add mg to both sides, and I'll go ahead and factor out an m while I'm working. So the tension is m times the quantity g plus a, and that's the general solution to the problem. But we have some numbers to plug in here. So I have a mass of 2 kilograms. G is approximately 9.8 meters per second squared. And the upward acceleration of this thing is 3 meters per second squared. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 25.6 kilogram meters per second squared, or newtons. In the next example, our 2 kilogram block is now resting on a horizontal surface. And there's still a string pulling up on it, but it's not pulling as hard. Now it's pulling with a force of 10 newtons. And the question this time is, what's the normal force on the block? So again, we start by putting in force vectors. And again, our weight is mg. The upward tension should also be represented as a vector. And I want to justify real quick why I made the tension vector shorter than mg. If we run the numbers on mg real quick, that's 2 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared. That's 19.6 newtons. In other words, a larger force vector than the 10 newtons tension pulling upward. And because that weight is bigger than the upward tension, I need another upward force vector if I'm going to balance that downward weight. Otherwise, the mass is going to start accelerating downward. And that third force is the normal force doing what it has to do to guarantee that all the perpendicular forces add up to zero and we keep this object constrained to the surface. Now, you may be able to guess that normal force already, but to deal with it a bit more formally, we are still applying Newton's second law here. We look at F net in the y direction, and that's equal to our mass times the y acceleration. Well, this object is stationary, so the y acceleration is zero. The right-hand side of this equation is just zero, and I can say F net in the y direction vanishes. So again, we use an upward is positive, downward is negative coordinate system. And my two upward forces are normal force plus tension. And then I have minus mg because the weight vector mg is pointing down. And that's all equal to zero. Now this time our goal is to solve for the normal force. So I add mg to both sides and subtract t from both sides. And I end up with mg minus t. And we already computed mg, that's 19.6 newtons. And we already know the tension, that's 10 newtons. And we find that our normal force is 9.6 newtons. Again, that's exactly what it has to be to guarantee that the mass remains constrained to this surface. In our final example, we have our same 2 kilogram block sitting on a smooth horizontal surface, and we're applying a force of 20 newtons pushing down and to the right at an angle of 30 degrees below the horizontal. In part A, we're going to find the normal force on the block, and then part B is kind of a review question. We're going to use Newton's second law to compute the acceleration of the block. So a natural starting point here is to decompose that force vector into its components, part of it's pointing to the right and part of it's pointing down. And that rightward component is the adjacent side of this right triangle with hypotenuse 20. So I have 20 cosine 30 for the x component of my force. Fx equals 20 newtons times the cosine of 30 degrees. And that's approximately 17.3 newtons pointing to the right. The downward component has the length of the opposite side of this triangle, and that's 20 sine of 30. That's a special angle. Sine of 30 is 1/2, so I get exactly 10 for Fy. That's 10 newtons pointing down. So if you like, we can just translate these vector components and attach them to the mass to make the diagram a little easier to look at. Now that we have those force components in the diagram, we add the other forces that we know are going on here. Of course, we have the force of gravity pulling down. That's the weight given as mg. And this block is resting on a surface, which means there's a normal force pushing up. Note that we want to take care to not double count our 20 newton force now. I've already decomposed it into components. Those are in the force diagram in magenta. So this has already been taken care of. Now to get the normal force, I want to analyze the vertical forces on this mass. I have the normal force pushing up, and then I have the weight of the object pulling down, in other words, the force of gravity. And then there's an additional 10 newtons down, which was the downward component of the applied force. Notice that as I was diagramming, I made the normal force a longer vector than either the weight or the downward component of the applied force. because I could tell at a glance the normal force is going to be equal to the sum of those two downward forces in order to balance everything out in the y direction. So this time, rather than taking the formal approach of writing down F net equals ma in the y direction, I'm just going to say, hey, the vertical forces balance. And there's nothing wrong with just computing a number on the weight in the diagram here. So I have a 2 kilogram mass, g is about 9.8. So my force of gravity, in other words, the weight, is 19.6 newtons. And I know the normal force needs to balance these. So my normal force must be 19.6 plus an additional 10 newtons, and that's 29.6 newtons. In part B, we want to compute the acceleration of the block, and that's happening in the horizontal analysis of the problem. Because my surface is horizontal and the block is constrained to the surface, the only acceleration that I can have is an x direction acceleration. And there's only one force in that direction. So we're really looking at the x component of Newton's second law, and writing down F net in the x direction is equal to the mass times the acceleration in the x direction. And what's F net? There's only one force, so that's 17.3 newtons. And the mass, of course, is 2 kilograms. And the acceleration in the x direction is what we're trying to solve for. So we simply divide 17.3 by 2, and I'll find my x acceleration. And that gives me 8.65 meters per second squared. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.